Hi, my name's Simon from Motodrome. Now today we're going to take a walk around and a drive off this 1973 Rover P5b Coupe that you can see lurking behind me here. Two videos, one walk around, one driving, plus a bit of engine starting and idling action at the end of both videos. Hope you like them. Okay, let's take a look around this rather lovely Rover P5b Coupe, 1973. It's actually one of the last 200 cars built, this one. Now I'm a bit biased because I love P5b coupes, but I'll try and be as objective as I can, but this one seems rather lovely. Arden Green with saddle tan interior was repainted, I think, in 2004, but Arden Green is its original colour. And in nice original spec, apart from it's got a Kenlo fan, it's got rear seat belts. This one's also got the four ET style headrests, front and rear. Nice chrome on it all round, including the Mazak chrome on the door handles and rear light units, all pretty good. And the interior is nice on this one as well. We'll show you in detail in a minute, but let's just start around the front. One or two minor stone chips on the bonnet, and the paint is, what, 18 years old now, so there are one or two blemishes in it here and there, like there. And the paint's a bit swirly on this side of the bonnet. Looks like it could do with a slightly better cut than it's been given. It's not too bad though. And so chrome is really nice on it. Show you the bits where they normally rust. Well, they normally rust everywhere, but up around the light units is always a good spot. Looking down the near side, it looks really, really straight and tidy down there. Door fits are good. The doors close with a nice clunk as well, and don't appear to have dropped. Look inside the arch, the front here. Rostyles are in good shape and the tyres are 3 years old. Still got its jacking points and its chrome trim down the bottom of the door. Bit of staining just here on the edge of the scuttle panel. Screen's in good shape. Roof is nice. Once again, could perhaps do with a slightly better cut. Paint looks slightly patchy on the roof, but I think that's down to a poor cut rather than anything else. Could be better. Near side door skin is all good. Near side door card is all nice. Bit of wear on some of the Furflex trim sort of around here. Carpets are in good shape. Leather's nice, as always on a P5B. You've got a very slight split just down here on the edge of the passenger seat, but all the stitching's in good shape on this one. Headlining. The toolkit is all there and all complete. Radio works. Dash is nice. The trim underneath the glove box is a little bit ragged now. Underneath the glove box and the radio. Front armrest is all good. Not too much wear on the tonneau carpet. Tread plates and then the A-post. And then in here, again, door card good, rear door good, D-post good. Again, no split stitching in the rear seats. All very, very nice. Wood's in nice shape, although some of it is slightly different colour. In fairness, as are the headrests, I think they've perhaps come out of a different vehicle. Yeah, headrests are a slightly different shade. As you say, doors close nicely. Near side rear wing, it's all good. Slight blemish just down here. Underneath the
windy here today.
Paint's looking a little bit tired just here around the fuel filler. This part of the seam is all good, but it's lost a bit of paint just there. This is looking a little bit tired here. Some areas you can see it's been over polished. Boot lid is all nice. So the chrome is particularly good on this one. And then in here, all the boot trim is all in place. Looking down the offside again, looks completely straight down there. Offside rear wing. Just again, looking at the seams. One or two tiny blemishes on the back of the wing. No more than that. Side rear door is nice. Rubber has lost a bit of its, well, snapped a little bit just there. We have got, I think there's a big box of spares that came with it. I think there's a whole new set of rubbers in there as well. Some of the rubbers, certainly on this door, are slightly past their best, as is really the rear screen rubber. Again, internally, really very nice indeed. No split stitching, unlike most of them. Again, doors close nicely. Driver's door, and down here is all good. Again, jacking points all present and correct. Slight blemish, bit of paint cracking just here, just above the indicator repeater on the passenger wing, and a bit of micro blistering just here. In fact, the whole top of the right front wing has minor micro blistering. But it was painted, as I say, 18 years ago, so I think you can excuse it, one or two blemishes. And then in here, driver's door, card and wood and everything. Driver's seat has had a repair in the bottom corner here. Nicely done repair, shame it's in a slightly different colour, but a nicely done repair for that. Again, the stitching's remarkably good. Bits of wear on the front of it, haven't actually split, but probably good feed won't go amiss. Nicely worn interior, shall we say, and dash is all nice. I like this, I really do. It's not a totally restored one, but then again, it's not going to be £40,000 and the rest. There we have it. My name's Simon. You can reach me in the office on 0118 907 1495. Go to our website, which is www.moto-drome.com. Okay, quick video of start up and idling on this P5b coupe. All light comes up is a bit dim, but it is there. Ignition light comes up as well, and settles down to a nice idle. As you can see, the other gauges, oil pressure's going up, ammeter, temperature gauge and fuel gauge. Just doing what it should. P5B engine. Idling sweetly.